So I'm going to show you a couple of tools that we have around column selection. So I'm going to go tools. So maybe you search a method, maybe it hits in the database, but maybe you don't have that column. Let me start this. Give me a second. So maybe you've identified a column, maybe from a journal reference, maybe from a hit in the database, but it's an old column and you don't currently have that column or it's not available anymore. So this is a column comparison tool where I can put in a column of interest that I'm interested in, that I want to use, but maybe I don't have. And I maybe want to compare it to what I do have in-house. So I can select a different column here. And using these Tanaka principles or parameters, it composes or calculates a column distance factor. So the smaller this factor, the closer those columns are to each other. And the higher the number, the more different they are and more orthogonal they are. So the also thing, the other important thing it does is it ranks the entire column database. If I drag this down, you'll see there's about 341 columns. It rank orders them in column difference. So I can right away start to see which columns might also be useful to me that I might have on the shelf in the lab that I don't have to go and purchase or try and purchase some old column. So very useful tool. I've used this in the past to just, even in column selection, so we've got a better column selection tool than this now, but what I used to do was I would look at a column difference factor and say, okay, I want to select that column. There's no point selecting this because it's so close to the other one, but maybe I want to select, you know, number 88, getting a bit different, and then select another one further down, getting a bit more different. So we want to cover a lot of chemistry space, right? So you can definitely do this in the column comparison tool. But with column selector, you can do this in a better way. And so I'm going to show you that next. So if I go to tools and column selection, and give it a minute to start. Okay, so again, I've got a list of a whole bunch of columns here that I can select from. I can add my own if they're not in the list, if you know the parameters that you can add. So what I've done here is I've selected four columns and which I want to move forward with. And I want to see how different they are, how orthogonal they are. Are they going to be useful in my method development? So if I go to next step down here, I get this clustering dendrogram, which I think KK showed a screen cap of, and showing when I click on the different columns here, in this three-dimensional view, it shows how the columns compare to each other. So you'll see in some of the parameters, they agree quite closely, and others they don't agree at all. So you can, again, get an idea of the diversity of the columns that you're looking at. Down below, you get a very detailed assessment of how those columns compare to each other and whether you maybe want to go back to column selection and maybe choose some other columns that you have. So again, a very, very nice way of defining columns that you might want to start doing in a method development project. So we did this recently, not recently, a couple of years ago, we did a very complex optimization of it was a three API system doing forced degradation. So quite complex chromatography. And we started off working with a customer from the very beginning, and they had originally proposed about four columns that they were interested in. And so we ran those columns and we saw that a couple of them, like two or three of them were quite similar. So there was really no point in doing the experiments on those columns. They were pretty much the same. So using column selection and So using column selection, what we did was we devised a better set of columns to start with. And so we started off the entire project on a very, very sound footing. So very, very cool tool. The other thing you can do is, so the next thing, if you have structures that you're interested in looking at, so the pH selection tool that KK mentioned. So if I wanted to save my columns that I've selected here, when I do pH selection, it's going to preferentially look at these columns that I've selected and how the structures run, or how those columns run at the pHs that the structures are best at.